السلام عليكم ورحمة الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Dear brothers and sisters, may Allah accept your siyam and your qiyam. Our parable for today is from Surah Al-Muddathir, verse 49-50-51. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم فما لهم عن التذكرة معرضين كأنهم حمر مستنفرة فرت من قسورة صدق الله العظيم. Why now turn they away from the admonishment as they were frightened asses fleeing from a lion? Imam Al-Qayyim Ibn Al-Qayyim, in his book, The Parables of the Quran, says about this analogy that the people of Mecca, whenever they see the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whenever he recites Quran unto them, they behave like wild asses in the desert whenever they hear or feel there is hunters or lions. So they take off in a chaotic way and they scare each other. So their turning back and their repulsive behavior against the Quran and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is indication of their ignorance. Not every noise means you are threatened in your life. By their act, they are wasting big opportunity for guidance and happiness. And why the Quran uses the humor, which means plural of asses, wild asses, I don't know. I looked in the tafsir, and maybe it's because it's a rigid animal, stubborn, timid, and maybe for other qualities. Maybe he has inferiority complex. You know, in the Indo-European language, the name for this kind of animal for the male is jackass, for the female is Jenny, and for the child is foal. It has very impressive title, Equus Africanus Asinus. It sounds like a Roman emperor, but he's an ass. His reputation is widespread, used by humans to slander each other and call names, though we are supposed not to call names. And apparently he went through crisis. And one day, well, the word donkey came to the English language, according to the dictionaries, in the year 1784. And nobody knows where did this word come. And in the encyclopedias, they said maybe it came from, and they gave 5, 6 explanations, none of them convincing. So really, they don't know. And I have a theory from my own, that the word donkey, the story or the parable goes as this, that the foal, the child of the donkey, one day came from school to his father and told him, the kids are picking up on me. They are bullying me. Can you do something, Dad? He told him, let me see. And he decided to change his name from jackass to something else. So he went to court and asked some experts, and they told him the word Don is very impressive. It in Spanish means Mr. or Master or even King. The graduate from Oxford University called Dons the fellows. So he liked it, and he said, well, I like the name Key also, Mr. Key, or Master Key, or King Key. And he made the word Don Key, And the child was very happy. He went to school, but he behaved in a stupid way and rigid way and stubborn way. And in no time, donkey became donkey equal to jackass. The change has not to come from outside. The change has to be from within to improve on your condition. After 9/11, one time I heard a segment on 90.1 NPR station I like about the courts being flooded with Muslims changing their names from Muhammad to Mo, from Ahmed to Amadeus, because they feel secure and they have, you know, a good feeling. But that fails, because in no time, whatever name you adopt or whatever outlook you look, if the change does not come from within, you will be at square one. If you don't put in your heart love and mercy and compassion, if you don't have ideals of love, of life and liberty and property, if you don't have principles of equality of conditions and respect to all mankind, if you don't have morals, dedication to honesty and truth and responsibility, if you don't have ethics at work of punctuality and hard work and all the PR relation with your fellows, if you don't have the etiquette and the decorum of society of courtesy and kindness and gentleness, you will not change anything by changing your names. So when you have a child, don't look for those kind of names which is they sound okay. Go to Muhammad and Ahmed and Mustafa. Go to Abdullah, Abdurrahman. Go to the names of Khadija and Zainab and Aisha and Ruqayya. And when you change what's inside you, those names will be jewels. They will be like Kareem Abdul Jabbar, respected everywhere. They will be like Muhammad Ali, respected everywhere. They will be like the Nobel Prize winner, Abdus Salam, and so on. In summary, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, He will not change your condition till you change what's inside you. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. May Allah bless you. Wassalamu alaikum.